Hello everybody, welcome to our design showcase. So what we used for our project was an epoxy resin that was reinforced with fiberglass, and we wanted to see if we were able to use any firearms to try and shoot through the epoxy resin. So on the left you see this is an example of what we would make. This would be a glass fiber weave that had epoxy matrix cured in between, and if you look on our right, these are the two types of ammo we used. It's a 9mm and a .223. So for the equipment that we used, we utilized wooden mold sealed with silicone tape to be able to put our tabletop resin and our hardener in. We also used cross-ply fiberglass sheets to put in between the resin itself, measuring cups, stir sticks, gloves, a butane torch to get the air bubbles out from the resin, and firearms and ammo for testing. We made sure for safety precautions, we had negative COVID tests before meeting with each other, adhering to the firearm safety policies within the gun range itself, and also awareness of the epoxy reaction could possibly be exothermic and burn us. Moving on to our reinforcement setup. So with our cross-ply fiberglass sheets, they are oriented in a 0-90 direction. We wanted to utilize a 0-45 90-degree direction to make sure that we had 8 degrees of tension to allow for better reinforcement. For lessons learned, you'll see at the end of the project that the epoxy with no reinforcement actually did better than the fiberglass reinforcement itself. So with some lessons learned with that, we thought about the binding between the epoxy and glass fiber material could be an issue, and as well as more curing time. We don't think we utilize enough curing time in between layers for it to be able to be properly used. And lastly, just a shameless plug, Devin Polk uses epoxy resins a lot, and these are some of the things that he makes. So if you want anything that is shown here, just hit him up.
All right, so the idea here is we're gonna make some armor plates using epoxy and fiberglass. So we're going to take fiberglass and lay it in one, and then put epoxy, fiberglass, and then layer it. And then on the other one, we're just going to do just epoxy, and we'll see how it comes out.
Yeah, so all I'm doing is we've measured out the fiberglass to put inside the epoxy. They're about 8.5 by 11, about the size of a piece of paper, and we're going to cut these out. And we'll be layering them in between a layer of epoxy. We'll be doing 5 sheets between each layer.
So what we're going to do is we'll talk about it in a video a little bit earlier, but the way we're going to do this is laying this way, and then this fabric here is going to actually be at a 45 degree angle compared to the other one, and we're going to put 2 of the regular ones on there, and then we're going to put a layer of the 45 degree one on there, and we're going to do that until we're out of sheets. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to do... this is a 1-to-1 ratio, so this is the epoxy. I'm gonna do 12 ounces of the epoxy, and then I'll do 12 ounces of the hardener, and then that'll give us 24 ounces, and we'll pour that between the two. And you have to get this exact, because if you don't, it won't harden.
Since we got some time to kill, I'll just cut my hair real quick.
So it is Taco Tuesday, so yeah.
Ready?
Good.
I'm gonna try to get that left corner.
Question. Where's your flashlight?
Get a flashlight. Pull a hole right here. It's right here as well.
That's really cool.